Hey, good morning, everybody. It is Saturday morning, March 27th. I'm sitting up here at the Flying J in Detroit, Michigan. Got a load, got to go down about 2 hours, 130-mile deadhead, I think it is, down towards Dayton, Ohio, picking up, going to... We're back out to Laredo, Texas. 1,450 miles. And it's like I said, 132, I think, deadhead miles. It's just north of Dayton. It ain't actually in Dayton. I think it's like 45 minutes or an hour before you get to Dayton. So... forget the name of the town, but yeah, that's where I'm going to pick up. It is 6:15 Eastern time here in Detroit. Roll over here and fill my tank up and head down south. So follow me there, guys. Having some people, I don't know if the light is good or not in here, but having some people asking me to just make a short video on how I strap stuff down. And so this is how I do it. Inside the E-Trax, you get these guys. Put one on each side. That's how I do it. Some of them have... Two on each side, on the front and back. But me, I just put one on each side. It's good enough for me, I think. But when you put one on each side, you gotta make sure they're on opposite side. You put it on here, I put the one here on this side, on the right side, and the back side, I put it on the left side. And all you do is you take your strap, make sure it's long enough. And you take your hook. You take your hook and you put it in this little guy right there. Bring it over, and then you put the other hook on this end. Go nowhere. And that's how I strap mine down. So as you just hook it in there, see that little hook right there, nice and tight, see, on that front end, and the other end on that end, and then you ratchet down and it's nice and tight. And there you have it. And that's how you strap it in.
All right, guys, I got all that done, got it loaded.
It was supposed to be 3 skids. Thought I was going to lose my bed there, but I didn't. Ended up only being 1 skid, 378 pounds. And we're going to Laredo. From here is 1,450 miles. It is Saturday afternoon at 2:30 Eastern time, and it don't deliver till Monday morning at 6 a.m. So I'll get to Laredo sometime tomorrow afternoon sometime, and tomorrow's Sunday, so usually a lot of stuff's closed on Sunday in Laredo, so we'll just plan on getting there, making sure we get unloaded 6 o'clock Monday morning, and like I said, I'll get to Laredo tomorrow afternoon or late or in the evening sometime, we're gonna go ahead and put all this in the computer and get it all situated. I showed you how I strap stuff in and secure my load. That's how I do it. I've had a couple people asking me to make a video or show, you know, a little something how I, you know, secure my load, and that's how I do it. A lot of videos I don't record me doing the, you know, securing the load, and just wanted to let people know that you gotta secure your load, man, because you never know what can happen out on this road. I know a lot of people are thinking that I don't secure my load, but I do. You gotta secure it. There's times I have 3 skids in here, and they're as wide as the van, and sometimes I can't get a strap inside my E-tracks. So there has been times that I didn't strap stuff down. But yeah, you got to make sure you secure your load and make sure stuff is secure and strap that stuff down, man. That's how I do it. And so, like I said, I'm going to get this paperwork in the computer and get on down the road and get me a good chunk of time in this trip to Laredo. So, all right, man, we'll catch you and talk to you guys later on, man.
Singing hallelujah in the middle of my storm.
In the middle of the storm, I sing.
See, where does he get his strength from? How can you be so strong?
You make me strong, my Lord.
Hold up to my King. Singing hallelujah in the middle of my storm.
In the middle of the storm, I see.
Where does he get his strength from? How can he be so strong?
You make me strong, my Lord.
Up to my King, singing hallelujah in the middle of my storm.
In the middle of the storm, I see.
Where does he get his strength from? How can you be so strong?
You make me strong, my Lord.
Up to my King, singing hallelujah in the middle of my storm.
In the middle of the storm, I sing.
Where does he get his strength from? How can you be so strong?
Make me strong,
so
my Lord.
Pull up to my King, singing hallelujah in the middle of my storm.
In the middle of the storm, I see.
Where does he get his strength from? How can he be?
sense, guys. It's actually dropping hail onto the van. It's raining hail. I don't know how big it is, but I can't see it. I can hear it. I can hear the hail hitting the roof. Been going on for about, I don't know, 45 minutes so far. I don't know how long it is. This storm is going to be, or how intense it is, I don't know. Cars and trucks still moving, so I'm going to keep on going.
if it's even, the water's getting so thick on the ground, I think we might even be getting flooded tonight. I can feel it in the van when I'm driving, you know, like a little hesitant. Yeah, we're going to get off here in this next section, guys, so stay tuned. Off the exit here, and I don't see a Lowe's. Lowe's won't be at the next exit. And all I see is a Speedway gas station there to the left, and then over here to the right is the Pilot. So yeah, we're gonna get off of this Pilot.
In 1,000 feet, turn left onto Old Highway 13.
I still got a half a tank here, so... yeah, we're gonna get off and check this out. Grab something to eat. Might even just stay here for the night. We'll see, I don't know. I still got about 14 hours to drive, though, so... here and check it out, man. I got people texting me, my girl and kids saying, pull over, Dad. My girl saying to go and get into a safe place. So keep them saying, I'm going to go ahead and go into the Pilot and check it out. So. All right, man. Y'all have a safe night. I'll give y'all an update here in a little bit. Hey, good morning, guys. How's it going? Well, give you a little update here. It's still storming. I got back on the road. It's about 4:15 Eastern time. I'm in Central time, so it's only 4:15 Central Time. That storm, man, it was pretty bad. And looking at the radar, it's like that all the way off and on, all the way to Texas through the night and all day tomorrow. So I figured in the area I was, there was I believe they said that there was a tornado that touched down like 2.5 miles west, and I'm going west, so I was like, well, I'll go ahead and park it and, you know, just keep myself safe and give me a couple hours of sleep and just get up, and hopefully the storm will be gone and I gotta drive straight 14 hours. I should get there around 7-8 o'clock tonight. But like I said, I don't deliver till 6 in the morning, so I got plenty of time. But the storm, it's still raining. When I was sleeping, the storm kept waking me up because it was pouring down and thundering and lightning, and it was just real bad. So I got up about 3:30 a.m. and got up and got dressed and said, well, let's get back on the road. And I looked at the radar and I was about 100 and some miles from Memphis, Tennessee, is where I was gonna stop anyways for the night. But there's another bad storm going through as I'm gonna be going through Memphis. There's some more real bad storm, but and it's supposed to be storming all day Sunday, all the trip to Texas. I looked at the radar and it's off and on. It's gonna be thunderstorming all the way to Laredo. So we just had to weather the storm, y'all. So it's still raining and stuff, and it looks like daylight's trying to creep in. So we'll get to the daylight and any more trouble, I'll keep y'all updated. But follow me on this journey back to Laredo. Hey y'all, how y'all doing? Good morning. It is Monday morning here in Laredo, Texas. I just got unloaded. I just got unloaded at 6 a.m. Central Time. I have weathered the storm. You've seen the storm I went through. And I made it to Laredo and got unloaded and getting ready to go in here to the pilot in Laredo. And give me a shower and hopefully get out of here. Apparently there's no one here right now within my company, so I'm the only one here. But I don't think I've ever seen this many vans here in Laredo. It is jam-packed down here. It's pretty busy. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. So, but yeah, man, that's it, man. I'm gonna jump off here and finish this up. Just wanted to show you how I went through that storm and came to Laredo and got unloaded. So, I'm gonna jump off here, go get me a shower, and see what we can come up with. So, all right, man. Till next video, man. God bless you guys. Y'all be safe out there.